गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए न्यू यूनिट दैट इज एसी सर्किट्स। सो इट्स ए फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ दिस यूनिट, सो सम बेसिक थिंग फर्स्ट आई विल डिस्कस एंड देन वी विल गो अहेड। आवर टाइटल इज एसी सर्किट्स, सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू मूव what is the meaning of AC and then go ahead. So if I'm talking about the nature of current, then you can see from this figure number A, here you see the current magnitude as well as the direction with respect to time is constant. So this position, if we have this type of the current, or we can say this type of the power supply, then we will call it is the DC supply. But you see in the second figure B, what you see here, the current is continuously changing. It means its magnitude is changing from zero to maximum, then again comes zero, then again moving maximum but in the reverse direction, and then again comes zero. So what we can say, its magnitude as well as direction both are continuously changing. So this is the periodic change here. So this type of the things is known as the AC or alternating current. There is a third case, and in this third case what we see here, we see the direction of current is same here, but you see the magnitude is continuously changing, maximum then becomes zero, then again increasing maximum and comes zero. So its magnitude is continuously changing. So this type of the currents are known as the pulsating currents, or you can say the this type of the waveform is the pulsating waveform. And this type of the waveform or this type of the current, if you know, I think you know about this, this type of the current we can achieve when we are using the full wave rectifier. That condition we will get this type of the output. So why we prefer AC? So there are three, four basic reason behind to that. In AC, voltage we can rise or we can load with the help of the transformer, because we are able to step up and we are able to step down the voltage. So that possibility is available with AC. Second, you can see if we are rising our the voltage, then our electrical transmission is possible, because at high voltage the current is low, and if current is low, then we can say there is the low copper losses, and also the lesser amount of conducting materials required there. So that's in these two current, we can say these two region, we can say okay, this makes AC transmission always economical and efficient. Third, what we can say, it is possible to build up high AC voltage, high speed AC generators of large capacity, because it's their construction and the cost is very low. High voltage of about 11 kV can be generated and can be raised up to 220 kV for transmission purpose, which I mentioned in point 2. At the sending end, we increase up to that using our step up transformer, and while can be lowered down 400 volt at receiving end. This type of the phenomena is not possible with the DC. AC electrical motors are simple in construction, are cheaper also, require the less attention for maintenance point of view also. And whenever it is necessary, then we are able to change our AC to DC also. So due to these advantages, AC is used extensively in the practice, and that's why we are here study about the fundamentals of AC circuits. If you are talking about the waveforms, we will use many times this word, the sinusoidal waveforms. So if we want to define the term of waveforms, it means a quantity which undergoes variation in its instantaneous wave. It means at a particular point we want to see the value, this point and this point, everywhere if you want to see the value, that is the instantaneous value, in the magnitude as well as the direction with respect to zero reference, it's called the alternating quantity. And the graph of such quantity against time, one quantity whose instantaneous value is in magnitude as well as the direction is continuously changing with reference to any reference, that quantity is known as the alternating quantity, and the graph of such quantity against the time is known as the waveform. I am representing here four type of the waveforms, used as square and triangular and trapezoid and the sinusoidal. But we prefer the sinusoidal waveforms among of these waveforms, because sine waves are frequently used, and the reason behind this is the mathematical representation of pure sinusoidal waveform is easy. Secondly, we can say the another type of the waveform can be resolved in a series of sine and cosine wave of fundamental and high frequency, and some of all these waves gives the original waveform. Third, what we can say, the sine and cosine wave are the only waves which can pass through linear circuit containing resistance, inductance and capacitance without distortion. In case of the other type of the waveform, then there is a possibility of distortion when it passes through the linear circuit. And another advantage is this, if we are taking the integration or the derivatives of sinusoidal function, it is again a sinusoidal function. It means the analysis of linear network with sinusoidal inputs is very easy. So these are some reasons due to this sine waves are frequently used for the AC system. Now, how the AC voltage is generated? So it's a very simple basic concept, and this in this diagram I'm showing this one, this basic concept. You see is the permanent magnet, the N2S. You can see the direction of magnetic flux here, these are the magnetic poles here, and you see here is the conductor. See, this is the conductor. Okay, these are the slip rings here. You can see it is the carbon brushes, and this we can say is the coil or a conductor or a wire loop, we'll call it. And its rotation is given like this way. You can see the axis of rotation here. So as per the very famous Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, when a single wire of conductor is rotating within this stationary magnetic field, this magnetic field is stationary, but this wire is rotating like this way. In this way, this wire is rotating in this stationary magnetic field, and due to the Faraday's law, what will be happen there? Here the EMF will induce here. So the EMF will induce within the conductor due to moment of conductor in magnetic flux. Is it okay? So this is the basic principle that electrical generator used to generate the sinusoidal waveform for our main supply. So if we are talking about any type of the generator, it's a very simple thing. We are putting there magnets and there is a coil, and this coil is rotating in a stationary magnetic field, and due to this there will be a induced EMF in the conductor. But if we are talking about a purely sinusoidal AC voltage, and that is generated, that type of the voltage is generated by the alternators. So if we are talking about the purely sinusoidal AC voltage, then we will call it as the alternator. Now you can see in this diagram how we can construct our AC component here, sinusoidal waveform. You can easily understand from this formula. I am taking two part here. One is the part which in the last slide I have shown the rotation of a conductor in a stationary magnetic field, that I will representing here. And when it is rotating here, then according to the value of induced EMF that we want to see here, how it is varying. So, and this variation will give us the sinusoidal waveform here, which represent our AC here. So you see at the starting in this, it means the theta is zero here. In this condition, there is no induced flux, so its value is zero here. But you see when we are increasing our value, and if we are coming, let us suppose it's the 45 degree, so that is nothing but the value of sine 45, and you are getting this one value. And if we are moving and comes at the point C, which you can see that it becomes the sine 90, it means this value is the maximum. So we are here and it is represented by Vmax. So basically I am talking about the instantaneous value here. You see this instantaneous value is nothing but is the multiplied by the maximum value multiplied by the sine theta. So theta is this variation I am discussing about, this variation. And you must remember in my previous classes I have discussed, when I am talking about the three-phase induction motor, you must always remember in electrical engineering we use electrical degree. So let me again clear your concept about the electrical angle and mechanical angle. So electrical angle is nothing but you can see from this diagram. This will show the electrical angle. So how I will define it, that a cycle of alternating quantity, divides into 360. So you see this is the 360. So how we can define our electrical angle? A cycle of alternating quantity divide into 360 divisions is called electrical angle. Is it okay? So this is the meaning of the electrical angle. But what is the mechanical angle, which you can see from this one? One revolution of coil is moving, start from this particular point and move like this way, and it's complete its revolution at again point A. So this type of the rotation is known as the mechanical angle. So we will represent it as the mechanical degree when one revolution of current, or you can say the one revolution of the coil, is divided into 360 divisions is called as the mechanical angle. And if I divide one cycle in 360 divisions, then it is called the electrical angle. So in electrical we will use that term is the electrical angle. So it should be very much clear in your mind. So what you see here, it becomes the maximum. Again, its value will decrease here. So you can see this value after maxima, it is decreasing here. And once again, if we are at 180, so the direction is just opposite here, but the magnetic field and the velocities here is the parallel. So in this case, this value becomes again zero here. Then again move in this direction, so it will be increased, but this values goes in the negative direction, or it this particular value 270 becomes maximum. And if you are moving it down to 360, it's again becomes equal to zero. In this case, again our velocity direction and our field is parallel here. So you see the generated EMF when a conductor is moving in the stationary magnetic field, then you can see the induced, there will be the induction of a EMF, and you can see the value of this EMF is continuously changing, goes maximum, then comes down, then comes down, then again it goes maximum in reverse direction, and then again comes down. So it's complete a one cycle. So this cycle is represented here. So basically you can see the instantaneous value of the EMF. Here we have the different value, here I have different value, here I have different value, here I have different value. So that value is given by this formula, V instantaneous equal to V maximum multiplied by the sine theta. And you see it is one cycle, complete cycle. And you see theta, theta is measured in radian. So basically at starting theta is zero, and then you can say it is increasing like this way. So it is theta is represented here radian. So this is given by the omega t, and omega is here the angular frequency, which is given by the 2 pi f. And this frequency, you know about this frequency, cycle per second. We can say the frequency is cycle per second, and it's basically depend on the speed of the rotation of the conductor, which is rotating here. This concept we already discussed in our induction motor. So this is the frequency here, and you know the time period, or you can see the periodic time, the time required to complete this one full revolution of the sinusoidal wave. So from this to this is given by capital T. And in this case, because the periodic time is inversely proportional to the frequency, so I can write here omega equal to 2 pi upon t, and it is nothing but it is given in the radian second. So why I am discussing all the things here? Because you are now able to write our instantaneous value of generated EMF in 2-3 form. It's a simple form, V max equal to sine theta. That theta you can write in terms of our angular frequency, and this angular frequency you can write in terms of our periodic time also. So this is whole about the introduction of the AC as well as the construction of sinusoidal waveform. In the next class we will discuss about the phasor notation of AC quantity and RMS value. I think you understood the basic concept of the AC. If you have any problem, then you can write email to me on sham@gwc.ac.in. Thank you.